There is one famous example of two-dimensional motion, that is rain and umbrella question. Rain is falling vertically with a speed of 30 meter. Woman rides bicycle with a speed of 10 from north to south. What is the direction to which she should keep her umbrella? Whenever if she is riding on a bicycle, should she keep her umbrella vertical? Practically we have seen it's not like that, because when we are traveling it appears to us that water is coming on our face from front and we tilt our umbrella. Okay, if the rain is there from this side, we will keep the umbrella in this. So umbrella is always kept in a direction exactly opposite to the direction of water which is coming to us. Okay, so what we are supposed to find out here? Answer we are supposed to find out here is the direction of rain. Direction is contained in what? Direction is contained in velocity, because velocity has got certain magnitude as well as direction. So if we know the velocity vector of the rain, but they say it is coming down vertically, then what we are supposed to find? It is vertically with respect to ground, with respect to ground, not with respect to the lady who is riding the cycle. When she rides a cycle, then it appears to her that rain is coming not in vertical direction but in some other direction. What do we call that in physics? In physics, when the observer is changing, we call it a relative velocity. So what we are supposed to find out is relative velocity of rain with respect to cyclist, not the relative velocity of rain with respect to ground, that is vertical, it's already given. So our target is to find relative velocity of rain with respect to cycle. This is our target, and this will give us magnitude as well as direction. Okay, now how to find it? The relative velocity. The relative velocity of rain. Velocity of rain is with respect to cyclist. With respect to cyclist is equal to velocity of rain minus velocity of cyclist. This is what we have studied in relative velocity. We find the relative velocity of rain with respect to cyclist by putting it minus between the two. Okay, now this we have to operate. First we will make velocity of rain vector. Velocity of rain is, the speed is 30 and the direction is vertical with respect to ground. So we make it here this. Let us suppose this is 10, 20, 30. This is what? A vector representing velocity of rain. Then velocity of cycle is to be subtracted from here, from the head. We make the velocity of cycle. The velocity of cycle is 10 meter from north to south. Suppose this is north, this is south. So the cyclist is going from north to south and the speed is 10, almost one third of it. Okay. If this is velocity of cyclist, then we put it here. This is velocity of cyclist. Okay. Now, what we want to do is the operation of subtraction, but this is positive. So, what we create is minus this, minus. Now, this is our starting point, Vr minus Vc, and if I draw this vector, what will it give? Answer, this will give Vr addition minus Vc. So, this will be Vr minus Vc, and this is what we need. Okay, so how much is this? This is 30. This is 10. What is this direction? I can draw a parallel line here, or I can draw a parallel line here, in any case. So this is, the lady is going in this direction, and this is the direction of, this is the direction of rain, what appears to her. Velocity of rain with respect to, velocity of rain with respect to cyclist is this, this. Velocity of rain with respect to cyclist. So this is how it is made. Now, what answer we are supposed to give you? What is this direction? We know this direction is north, this direction is south, that is east and west. We are not concerned with that. This is vertical. Where should the lady put her umbrella? Answer, she should put it against the rain water. If the rain water is following in this direction, she will put her umbrella in this direction. This is umbrella direction. This. So what we are supposed to inform? We have to inform this angle with respect to vertical. So our information will be from the vertical, the lady should keep her umbrella towards south. She should tilt her umbrella towards south. One answer. Other way, she is going in this direction. So we can say that she should tilt her umbrella in forward direction. There are two names of the direction, south or forward. So here you can use any of this. So she can tilt the umbrella in forward direction, but how much is to be tilted? That we must inform this angle, and it's quite easy. If we complete a right angle triangle here, then this is 10, this is 10. This is 30. So tangent theta is equal to 10 upon 30, that is 1 upon 3. If tangent theta is 1 upon 3, then theta is equal to 10 inverse, 1 by 3. So this is the angle. So what will be our answer? See this part with respect to vertical, because if it is certain angle, whether it is with respect to horizontal or with respect to vertical, this we must mention, otherwise our answer will be incomplete, not clear. So this we have mentioned, that this is with respect to vertical. That means first the umbrella is in vertical direction, then the lady is going in this direction, it should be tilted in forward direction by a certain angle with respect to vertical. This is how it is made. Please remember, we should always make a triangle, and this triangle with the minus, first cycle is to be reversed as negative, then we should add this VR, velocity of rain, which is vertical, with this. This gives us the resultant VRC, VRC, and this umbrella has to be kept against the rain. So this was a very famous question, rain and umbrella. There is another famous question every student is supposed to do, that is, when somebody is crossing the river, he is applying certain force, maintaining certain velocity to cross the river, but at the same time a velocity is being applied on it by the water of the river in this direction. So when he is going here crossing the river, the water is pushing him this way. So he goes like this, and lands up somewhere else, not here. This situation can be resolved by using two-dimensional analysis, and we can always find that if he wants to reach the other way at the earliest time, how he should swim, And if he wants to reach the other way by going through the minimum length of path, then what direction he should follow? That is a little tricky situation, but you can always remember that. We will do it in the next question. Thank you.